Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about life cycles of plants. Under this, haplontic life cycle, diplontic life cycle and haplodiplontic life cycle. Very first one, haplontic life cycle. The sporophytic generation is represented only by one-celled zygote. There is no free-living sporophytes. Meiosis in the zygote results in the formation of haploid spores. The haploid spores divides mitotically and forms gametophyte. The dominant photosynthetic phase in such plants is the free-living gametophyte. This kind of life cycle is termed as haplontic life cycle. Many algae such as Volvox, Spirogyra and some other species of Chlamydomonas shows haplontic life cycle. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of haplontic life cycle. Most of the algae and fungi shows haplontic life cycle. Here in this haplontic life cycle, zygote is the only diploid cell. The remaining life cycle is haploid. When zygote form, the diploid zygote undergoes meiosis and forms adult gametophyte, which is in haploid condition. Haploid gametophyte undergoes mitosis and forms gametes. These gametes fuse to form diploid zygote. Here you have to know, in haplontic life cycle, the only diploid cell is zygote. Diplontic life cycle. On the other extreme is the type of where in the diploid sporophyte is dominant, photosynthetic, independent phase of the plant. The gametophytic phase is represented by the single to few-celled haploid gametophyte. This kind of life cycle is termed as diplontic life cycle. An alga, fucus-like species, represents this type of diplontic life cycle pattern. In addition, all seed-bearing plants, which means gymnosperms and angiosperms, follow this pattern with some variations, wherein gametophytic phase is few to multicelled. In diplontic life cycle, gametophytic phase is highly reduced, which means it is few to multicelled. Generally seen in higher plants and some algal species like fucus. Let's check the diagrammatic representation of diplontic life cycle. In this, so adult spore producing diploid 2N undergoes meiosis to form spores. Then these spores germinates and undergoes mitosis to form adult gametophyte, which produces haploid gametes. By the process of gametogenesis, these gametes fuse to form zygote. Then zygote undergoes mitosis to form embryo. Then this embryo germinates into new diplontic sporophytic plant. Let's check this diagram carefully for your better understanding. Haplodiplontic life cycle. Bryophytes and pteridophytes interestingly exhibits an intermediate condition between haplontic life cycle and diplontic life cycle, which is called haplodiplontic life cycle. Both phases are multicellular, however, they differ in their dominant phases. A dominant, independent, photosynthetic, thalloid or erect phase is represented by a haploid gametophyte, and it alternates with the short-lived multicellular sporophyte, totally or partially dependent on the gametophyte for its anchorage and nutrition. All bryophytes represents this type of pattern. The diploid sporophyte is represented by a dominant, independent, photosynthetic, vascular plant body. Haplodiplontic life cycle is intermediate type between haplontic life cycle and diplontic life cycle. So here both the phases having multicellular condition. Generally, it is common in bryophytic plants. It alternates with multicellular sporophytic or autotrophic independent but short-lived haploid gametophyte. Such pattern is known as haplodiplontic life cycle. All pteridophytes exhibits this pattern. Interestingly, while most algal genera are haplontic, some of them like Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia, Kelps are haplodiplontic, which means brown algae shows haplodiplontic life cycle, but Fucus is the algae which shows diplontic life cycle. Here we have to know the algal species, particularly brown algal species shows haplodiplontic life cycle, such as Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia and other kelps. But Fucus is the alga which shows diplontic life cycle. And most of the pteridophytes exhibits this haplodiplontic pattern. Let's check the diagrammatic representation of haplodiplontic life cycle. So in this phase, adult diploid sporophyte is 2N, which undergoes meiosis to form haploid spores. These haploid spores germinates into haploid gametophytes. So these haploid gametophytes undergoes mitosis, which is called gametogenesis, to form male gamete and female gamete, which are fused to form diploid zygote. This diploid zygote undergoes mitosis to form diploid embryo. This diploid embryo develops into a diploid sporophytic plant. Let's check this diagram carefully for your better understanding. Up to here, the chapter Plant Kingdom was completed. In next video, I will start new chapter. Thank you very much.